नमस्कार फ्रेंड्स, प्रोफेसर ब्रह्म सिंह हॉर्टिकल्चर फाउंडेशन BSHF, ए नॉट फॉर प्रॉफिट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड मायसेल्फ वेलकम यू ऑल टू द टॉक नंबर 10 ऑफ दिस सीरीज 3H, हॉर्टिकल्चर फॉर हेल्थ एंड हैप्पीनेस। आई वेलकम both the organizers, Dr. Peetham Kalia, ICR Rafi Ahmed Kidwai Awardee and former head division of vegetable science IARI New Delhi, and Dr. Shailendra Rajan, director ICR Central Institute of Subtropical Horticulture Lucknow, to moderate the webinar. BSHF is thankful to Syngenta, Patanjali Ayurved Limited and NHRDF to sponsor this webinar series. The talk this evening is on protected crops and health, opportunities and challenges by Dr. Navaneesh Singh, National Protected Crop Manager, India, Syngenta India Limited, Pune. BSHF is thankful to him to honor our request to deliver the webinar. Friends, as you know, protected cultivation, which creates appropriate condition or climate for the growth of plant, is becoming increasingly important in horticulture crops due to uncertain and frequent drastic changes in climate, increased demand of off-season vegetables particularly, and other things. This is important base or technology for urban agriculture or horticulture. I call it generally urban horticulture, which would be smart or high-tech horticulture in near future. We will be seeing a lot of it. World over, protected crops are multiplying and India is no exception, but not to the desired level. Some farmers have done extremely well even in state like Rajasthan. Such things and other important aspects of protected crops, we hope, would be highlighted by the speaker. The speaker, Dr. Navaneesh Singh, would be introduced by Dr. Peetham Kalia. Questions can be raised in Hindi or English for answer in question answer session after the talk. Now I request Dr. Kalia to introduce the speaker. Dr. Kalia, please.
Thank you, sir. Good evening. A most respected Professor Brahm Singh ji, co-organizer Dr. Shailendra Rajan ji, and today's speaker Dr. Navaneesh K. Singh ji, and the viewers. It's our pleasure that we are having today's talk on very important topic, that is protected crops and health, opportunities and challenges, by none else than Dr. Navaneesh Singh ji, who has had his graduation and master's from Chandrasekhar Azad University of Agriculture and Technology, Kanpur, and has his doctorate from Banaras Hindu University, Varanasi, along with the postgraduate diploma in business administration from Symbiosis in Pune. Dr. Navaneesh Singh has 20 years of experience in seed industry, which includes a contribution for assignments related to various R&D functions, sales and marketing. Dr. Navani started his career from Mahindra Seeds in 1998 and worked for 7 years in various roles from breeder to research coordinator and later leading the technical service functions. For almost 15 years, he has been in Syngenta, where he is now National Protected Crop Manager based at Pune. And prior to that, he has had roles leading the trialing functions and APAC trialing and operational excellence lead roles. So Dr. Navneet Singh has a very good experience, and presently he is leading the protected crops nationally. So it would be our pleasure to have a talk from him, and I'm hopeful that this subject is very futuristic, which is taking on, and the viewers who will be joining and who has already joined would be benefited to a greater extent from Dr. Singh's experience. With this, I invite Dr. Navneet to deliver his talk. Floor is yours, Dr. Navneet. Please go ahead.
Thank you, Dr. Brahm Singh, for inviting me for this webinar. And thank you, Dr. Skadia, for sharing my profile to all of you. And I am audible, actually?
Yes.
Okay. So, good evening, all of you. I welcome all in this... I want to share my presentation, actually. Yeah.
Oh, you share comfortably.
Yeah.
You share and start speaking.
This is fine.
It will come. It will come. It will take little time.
Okay.
So please share again.
I am sharing. So it is coming.
No, sir. No, it's not visible here.
स्टॉप करके फिर करिए.
इज दिस कमिंग?
इट विल कम. इट हैज कम.
यस.
आप थोड़ा सा करिए जो करना होता है.
जूम कर लीजिए सर.
इसका जूम करिए. जूम
डबल.
हाँ. गुड. आराम से. यस. वेरी गुड.
सो गुड इवनिंग ऑल ऑफ यू. आई वेलकम ऑल इन दिस प्रोटेक्ट क्रॉप एंड हेल्थ अपॉर्चुनिटीज एंड चैलेंजेस. एंड सो दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक एज डॉक्टर ब्रह्म सिंह मेंशन. सो एक्चुअली प्रोटेक्ट क्रॉप इज इन नेसेंट स्टेज बिकॉज एट ग्लोबल लेवल इट इज वेरी वेल डेवलप्ड. But when we see at the grower level, so polyhouse, net house, so it need more development. So, but particularly this topic today regarding this health. So health is very important for all of you. And if you see the COVID time, so everybody more cautious about the health because it linked with immunity. We have to fight with the COVID and all these things. So potato crop is a avenue where we can grow the crop. Healthy crop we can grow very effectively, and that I am covering here. So I take you through agenda. So actually I will cover here the history of potato crops and what is the current global and Indian scenario. I will cover some scope benefits of potato crops and importance also. So I give some basics of net house and polyhouse, and I will cover some economics of cucumber and capsicum. So, and what is the role of Senta towards these protected crops, and finally, health benefits? Really, I feel this protected crop is a smart cultivation. Can you see, if you see this fourth picture, it is very clear, very neat and clean. And when you see the plants, very uniform growth, very proper spacing, and very good bearing, and every plant is taken care and have proper pruning and proper trestling. So it is very smart cultivation. The reason is actually here. So this technique control partially or fully the microclimatic condition surrounding the plant, and which lies its maximum potential even in adverse climatic condition. So here you can, in normal condition, plant give high yield, and when there is condition of stress, it also give the maximum yield compared to open field. I just take you through history. So normally vegetable grow from this 1000 year to 7000 BC. But here there is a quote, necessity is the mother of invention. So there is a Roman emperor, Tiberius. So at the start of this century, actually he liked vegetable. And you know, Europe is much colder, and you cannot grow vegetable or cucumber outside in. I think maybe they have some innovative person who find a way. He grow cucumber in cart, and in daytime he bring cart in outside, and in the night time he take the cart inside the building. So basically, plant can survive at give the cucumber fruits, and king was very happy because he getting the fruits daily. So the first artificial heated greenhouse reported in Korea in 1450s, but major work started in 19th century with in France and Netherlands. But it was mainly low cost glass house structure used for ornamental purpose, and in but major work start after this World War. So major technology work started in Europe. So basically, Europe is more cold. They're working towards the developing the technology towards the mitigate the cold condition. And Israel, he is facing the heavy high heat condition. So they work toward mitigating the high heat condition. So at its time, there is a flexible low price polythene sheets used, and there is alum and polycarbonates, because they focus more on actually how you can reduce the weight and reduce the cost. But if we see the current scenario, the structures are quite modular, automated, computerized, lightweight structure you can find. This is very important slide. When I see this slide, I really surprising what will happen in future. So we have to be very cautious now actually. So if you see here, just 1 minute, you see 1950, the population was 2.6 billion people. We are, when you see this in 2020, they are 8 billion people. When you see in 2050, they are more than 9 billion people. If you see this 1950, the population ratio of developed and developing countries is 30% and 70%. 30% staying in the developed country and 70% in developing country. But you see the 2050 scenario, so there are 10% people staying in the developed country and 90% developing country. You see the graph of developing country, it is moving toward very high. It is around 8 billion people compared to 1 billion people in the developed country. So in case of developed country, there is no more issue because they have no problem resources, all these things, they can maintain their lifestyle. But if you see this developing country, they have more population. So there may be a competition for resources like land, labor. When population increasing, so you need more food, and there is more focus on infrastructure, more housing, so land will cut down. So what happened there? But you have to feed the people. Focus here, you have to feed the people. So we believe protected condition will help in feeding the people here. This is also a very important slide you can see here. So in globally, there are 1600 million hectare land. And if you see the 1965 scenario, so there are average one person have 0.6 hectare land. But you see now actually after this 50 years, so there is only 0.3 hectare land per person. In 50 years, the reduction of 50% land. So means what will happen after the next 50 years. So maybe it may be around 0.15 or 0.1 hectare per person. So it is very challenging situation. So maybe, but we have to feed the people. So these new technologies will certainly help to feed the people. So you see, the Indian scenario is not very good. So if you see the last 50 years, so if you see in the last 50 years, so people have 0.3 hectare land per person. But you see the current scenario, so we have only 1.12 hectare land per person, means 1200 square meter land per person. So what will happen after 50 years? So maybe it will be around 700-800 square meter land per person. So it is a very grim scenario. So maybe we can think on actually how to feed the people, but we also think on how to cut the, reduce the population, all these things, because they are competing with our all our resources. And maybe if we see our lifestyle, maybe not improve because all these population pressure. Predatory collection is playing major role in food security and health awareness in India. So just I mentioned here in the case of population pressure. So we will have around 1.5 million people in 2030. As you see the current scenario, we have only 1200 square meter land per person. So basically population is growing, land is shrinking. So there's a reason pressure come on how to increase the yield. Second is adverse climatic condition. So normally this protected crop very supportive in case of adverse climatic condition. You can get better yield in case of adverse climatic condition. So compared to this open field, and water will be scarce because in many states you can see in Karnataka, Rajasthan, part of Rajasthan and Gujarat, there is water issues. But this protected crop, you can cover almost double the area than the area covering open field. One more benefit is you can get the crop around the year. So normally you see in case of capsicum, you can get the capsicum full year, and you can get this cucumber also in June or July also, because mostly growing in this net house. And it bring this consistency. You can get the vegetable full year and full year supply. So this is very supportive. And that's the reason actually, if you see the other country like Europe and Israel, so they develop this technology and they are getting the vegetables fully here. Regarding this health awareness, so increased focus on organic. So people are very aware of how they make the health and how they can fit. They want to eat good food and fresh vegetable, and they have less pesticide. So that's the reason protective condition help in this people get the right vegetable with less pesticide. And finally, when the yield increase and quality improve, farmer will get the extra money and his income will be improved. One thing actually you learn from in the COVID time, because grow vegetables. So in COVID time, people more aware of this health and more aware of this increasing immunity. So vegetable consumption increase per person during this COVID time. And that's the reason when the consumption increase, so we need to focus on how to increase the this vegetable production. The question come, why go for protected cultivation actually? So here you can see the protected production from harsh climate condition like rain, hail, storm, low high temperature and humidity, you can control in protected crop. And there is good government support by subsidy. I thanks to NHB, NHM and the state government, they are giving 50 to 90% subsidy to the growers. It really helpful in supporting this protected crop this poly of net house. And because the cost is very high and this subsidy is very helpful in increasing this poly house and net house cultivation. Off-season production for extended period and continuous supply. Because they are these poly house, net house structure supporting this, you can extend your production cycle and you can grow vegetable in off season also. So it is very helpful. You can get the vegetable full year. And fourth one is saving in pesticide uses, because when you, the name is protected cultivation, and you when you grow the crop in poly house and net house, so entry of insect is not possible, but so you can save the pesticide there is better control in poly house and net house, but there is certain issue because Grover is not maintaining well these poly or net house, then the problem comes. But you maintain your poly or net house very well, there is no more issue and crop will be very healthy. This technology is very helpful in water saving and weed management. Normally drip system is used coupled with the mulch. So when you use the drip, so it is water saving. And in case of mulch, you can save water, and because it protect, it help in checking the water evaporation, and there is a proper weed control. So what is happening, your poly or net house is very clean and there is no weed issue. So there is no more pest issue in the poly house and net house. This is very important actually. I really like this in case of protected cultivation. Use of waste, barren and problem land. Normally what happen when you see any waste land like salt affected and barren land and problems land. So what happened in previously, there is no proper use of the land. So now with this new technology, this protected cultivation, you can use that land because you can make a poly house, you can make net house, you can bring soil from other places, and even you can use hydroponics so that you can increase the value of the land. So you can increase your area and you can increase your income with this technology. And finally, production of healthy, high quality produce with high ROI. Normally when you grow a crop like tomato grow outside, it is giving 25-30 MT per acre. But when you grow in a poly house, it gives around 60-70 MT per acre. So when you have 2 to 3 times yield, same in cucumber and capsicum also, your return will be increased. So these are suitable crops for protected cultivation. Here, there are many crops, but if you see the Indian scenario, capsicum and cucumber are the major crop growing under poly house and net house. And there is certain area for tomato also. Lettuce also have very limited area. The rest of the crop normally grower growing some experimental basis, they feel. So, but if you see the capsicum and cucumber, they are covering around 95% area. So this 1 or 2% area covered by this tomato and rest of the area covered by this lettuce, spinach, brinjal, gourds, all these crops. So this is the global scenario. If you see the total greenhouse vegetable area is 4,96,000 hectare. And if you see the China is number one, China has 2,76,000 hectare area. Followed by Korea, Spain, Japan. So you see most of the country which are cold, this technology is very popular. And this technology is very popular in case of a country which have high heat and very tropical condition. So normally in India, actually, it is, we have not much area. It is around 6,250 acre. It is based on industry estimates. So normally it covers both floriculture and vegetable area. So vegetable has around 4,000 hectare area. The rest is under floriculture or other purpose. So what I mentioned earlier, actually, if you see the vegetable protected area, it is around 4,000 hectare. And you see as per crop wide division, so it is 55% area under cucumber, 40% under capsicum, and less than 3% under cucumber and other crops. So here actually you see the capsicum and cucumber, if you grow in poly house, so normally it is an annual full year crop. So you cannot take other crop. But normally there is a good benefit in terms of cucumber. You can take at least 2 to 3 crops in a year. So you can increase your value and income. You see the Indian scenario. So normally capsicum is grown in most of the states. Normally in east area, it is a high humid condition, high temperature condition. That's the reason it is not much popular. But normally go to north, south and central. The technology is quite popular. And you see the Rajasthan, cucumber is a major crop. And grower also grow tomato, and there is certain area for capsicum, but in rest of the area you can see it is a tomato, capsicum and cucumber area is there. So currently when we see this area, it is around 4,000 hectare, but it is gaining momentum and many companies are coming. So normally we expect maybe next 5 years, it may be around 10,000 hectare. So just give some idea or basic idea on this active and passive greenhouse. So normally active greenhouse is because it use sunlight and also use heating and cooling system to control the temperature. Normally these are active greenhouse are not used in India, used in the developed countries, and these are high tech and very costly. But normally in India they are passive greenhouse, so there is no cooling system, no heating system there, and there is no moving component there, and it is naturally controlled, and it can cover anti insect net house, poly house, shed net, low tunnel, and walkway tunnel. So there are multiple options to grow vegetable in different structure. So first one is high tech or climate controlled greenhouse. So they have high degree of climate control. You can control high temperature and low temperature also. And they also have evaporative cooling and heaters are used to maintain the temperature. So these are mostly made of high quality plastic or glass house. And mostly these are used in developed countries. Semi-climate control greenhouse. So they are these have exhaust fan and evaporative cooling system pads are used. It maintain favorable temperature and humidity during summer. And these are suitable for growing vegetables during mid-winter and summer. Most of the YPR and nursery people, they are using such type of this semi-climate control greenhouse because they grow the nursery. Third one is naturally ventilated or low-cost poly house. So in these are very common, and these type of poly house cover 50% of area in India. And top of the greenhouse is covered with plastic, and insect proof net is side walls. So their lifespan is 10 to 12 years, and it is most commonly used in India. Last one is naturally ventilated or low-cost net house. And these are simply form structure. They are using shed net and insect proof net. So these are temporary and these are permanent structure also. So most commonly used and quite popular among growers. So these are different production system, how to produce the vegetables in poly house and net house. I'm just showing here. So first one is a geoponics and soil system or ground system. So this is very common system in India. Most of the 90% production in India, it is through soil system. It is very economic. And here you can directly grow in a natural soil condition, and mulching a drip system is commonly used in this type of system. And most commonly used system for growing cucumber and capsicum. Then soilless culture. So growing vegetable in media other than soil is soilless culture. So here you see the container here. So a container used here, and use peat, perlite, vermiculite, sawdust, rock wool as a media. And these are different type of container used for square, round, normal container used. And there is drainage hole here. And usually used where the issue of soil pathogen and nematodes. Normally what happened in India, so normally in cucumber and capsicum, there is no crop rotation. Grower either use capsicum in the same polyon net house or maybe use same cucumber one after another. So nematode is a major issue in case of in like Rajasthan and Maharashtra and Haryana also. So this technology is very useful in case of you want to increase your yield. Third one is hydroponic system. So growing plant in nutrient solution without soil. So it is a very limited level used in India and need more knowledge of plant growth, nutrient balance, culture media, and plant physiology. It is normally used by at university level and an institution level or a big entrepreneur. They are using this technology because it need high investment, and if a very silly mistake in case of calculation of exact fertilizer may lead to end of the crop failure. And you need the light also, because light is one of the issue in India. So you have no light, so maybe you're not providing the proper nutrition, so maybe crop failure will be there. Last one is aeroponic system. It is mostly used for research purpose, not commonly used by the growers. So if you see the overall system, geoponic system is very important used by maximum grower. And few grower use soilless culture where there is an issue of nematodes and build issue. So these are different structure used differently as per grower needs. So normally I mentioned the use of poly house, net house and shed net. So this trench cultivation is also conducted normally in hilly areas. You can see the trench is here and it's covered by polythene sheets in the evening or night. So you can save the crop here because it can retain the high heat, the temperature in night time. So crop will be saved. And the plastic load tunnel also very popular in many parts of North India. And because you can see here, when you grow the nursery in open field, need to cover the crop. It's safe from water, rainfall, and from air. And it retains the moisture, so your seedling will be very good. So it is mostly used in case of nursery growing. Last one is floating this cover. So normally, I think maybe many people remember when they go by train to Delhi or maybe near Ganga. So many people are using this cover because it protects the crop from frost and cold. So grower normally use, if grower need early return from the crop, so they grow early in January and February at a time this cold climate is there. So normally they can save the crop by using these technologies. So I just give you some example of how the grower is using this technology in a different way. So this is temporary net house and economic structure. I'm showing the real photos of the net house in Bangalore and Palghar. So normally in Bangalore, normal net house size is 1 acre and 1/2 acre. But Palghar grower, it is a big size. Although they are using 1 acre, 2 acre, but many grower have this net house more than 10 to 12 acre. So the cost is very low, 50 to 100 rupees per square meter. And they get the yield of 3 to 4 kg for capsicum. And 3.5 kg for capsicum. So what happened, normally they install these temporary structure when they after transplanting. So when the crop is around 1 feet, they install this structure. And when the crop is finished, they also remove all the structure, keep in safe place. Again, they use the structure when the crop will come. So this is another economic structure used by grower. And this is permanent poly house structure. The cost is around 750 to 1000 rupees per square meter. So normal grower take 8000 to 1000 plant per acre, and production is around 4 to 6 kg per plant for capsicum, cucumber 4 to 8 kg, and tomato 6 to 10 kg. So you can see the very good crop growth, and it is a real photo of a grower, and they work very hard to maintain their crop. This is a new technology, retractable roof production system. Crevo is a major company in India. They are providing such structures. It is costly, and you see the crop is very nice, very good looking, and very high link potential. So what is the benefit of this retractable roof production system over this poly house, net house? So what is happening, you see the roof, it is open and closed as per your need. So here you can see the plant is getting full light in daytime. And you can close the structure in night time. So normally what happened in poly or net house, so here plant is not getting the full light. So compared to retractable, so growth is good in case of the plant growth in retractable structure. Here yield is quite high compared to other system. Color capsicum 15 to 20 kg per acre, per square meter. And green capsicum 20 to 25 kg per square meter. Cucumber yield is 40 to 50 kg per square meter, and tomato 40 to 50 kg per square meter. If you see the calculate in acre in empty term, so it is around 160 MT to 200 MT per acre. So it is quite high yield, but this system is costly, so but it gives very high yield. So this is the future of agriculture. So normally we grow crops in normal flat land and maybe soilless with soil. But in future you can grow like in vertical, maybe it is like buildings, maybe it is very popular in the country, but now India it is early stage. So, but it is very popular in other countries. I just sharing this photo, I visited one grower actually I mentioned that you can use the wasteland and which is not useful. So this is just example I am showing. So it is a hilly area. There nothing is grown except just plants. And the rural made a poly house on the hill where you're going to grow the normal crop. And whatever, he bring the soil from other places and he make a water tank. He store the water harvesting, rainwater harvesting, and use this water for the irrigating this poly house, because there is no water source nearby, but he using the rainwater. So it is one of the good example how you can develop the wasteland converted into a cultivated land. So this protected condition also helpful in improving the seedling quality in the nursery, because many YP are using this technology. And what is the benefit of this? It give high germination rate, better care of young plant and virus free plants. What happening, your this seedling is affected. So when you take the seedling to grow in the field level, so it will again affected. And what happen, you can find more virus. Virus the biggest issue in case of field level. So better to take a healthy seedling in the field, so you can get more yield and it create value to you. One more benefit of this nursery growing in this poly under houses, because grower has more time to focus on field activities and then raising the nursery. So he has more time. So you see here, very good seedling and very good growth, uniform growth. So grower getting more yield in field. So this protected cultivation is most commonly used in breeding program also. So it one way help in increasing the crop cycle. Normally what happen in 1 year, you can take out for one cycle, but in case of this using this technology, you can take 2 to 3 cycle in a year. In calico also, you can take 2 generation per year, and in wheat also, you can take 6 generation in a year. So normally most of the companies are using this net house, poly house for crossing and selfing purpose. And you can see here, this false wall structure using for this crossing purpose also. So protected cultivation have major role in case of increasing the official efficiency of vegetable quality seed production. Most of the vegetable seed production done under net house and poly house. And what is the benefit actually? So it helps in obtaining best quality of seed, because no fungal or bacterial infection with the better seed yield, and improve the export potential of seed in. What happened, India is a can be a good hub for seed production. So if you see the role of India in global seed export, we have only 1% market share. And you know, our labor cost is very economic and we have very different conditions. So there we can have better production. So we can export these things. We have a scope to increase our production, and that can benefit to the growers. So many companies in India, which are actually from other countries, they started production in India because due to low cost of production. So in the India, certain states, certain location are hub for seed production. I really feel Ladakh is one of the option to explore off-season seed production location from April onward. Because normally what happened after September to this March, April, temperature is very low, but after this April, temperature is going high, so maybe it can be used as a best production location using this technology. Yes. So although I just talking on what is a good thing in this technology, but there is some constraint in greenhouse vegetable cultivation. So one of the basic constraint is basic cost of construction and operation cost is quite high. Normally, in case of poly house, it costs around 30-35 lakh per acre. Net house also costing 15 to 20 lakh per acre. So it is surviving only because government is giving subsidy. So cost should be, it is one of the constraint, and lack of standardization of greenhouse as per agro-climatic region. So what happening in India, there are different climatic zones, and the temperature, climate, rainfall is very different than other zones. But normally what happen, you find the same this poly or net house in all the area. So we need to customize as per the region and condition, local condition. And Normally, what happen in case of when grower take the subsidy? So usually government gives 50% subsidy, but grower rest of the cost grower has to pay. And normally he has taken loan from the bank. So normally interest rate are 8 to 11%. It is quite high for grower because normally if he paying 15 lakh rupees, so for grower it is quite high. He has to pay the interest rate. In India, we have very different conditions like Rajasthan, say sandy loam soil, not just sandy loam, Maharashtra, black soil, and you see the south, it is red soil. But normally we are using the same production technologies. So normally it need to be changed or we have to use as per local condition. Grower training and program and awareness. This is another area because normally what happened through government subsidy, grower make this all these poly of net house, but really don't know how to grow the crop. When I visited in Rajasthan, so poly houses are like empty and the crop growth was very poor actually. So there should be awareness for to grower for they go for training. Lack research, specific research program to breed hybrid for Indian market. Mostly most of the hybrids in India are imported and need to be focus on some breeding program for India. They can develop hybrid for local condition. Last one is very important for a grower. Normally, although grower take more pain for producing this capsicum, cucumber, all these protected crops, but when he go to the market, he is not getting the right price. So just give the example, normally when we discuss grower, he say, I am getting 10 rupees, 20 rupees per kg for capsicum, green capsicum. But when you go in the shelf in this all these super store, so their cost is around 80 and 90 rupees or maybe 100 rupees. So what happened, normally grower is getting only 1/3 of the price what normally end customer is paying. So it is a really pain point and I really feel if grower getting good price, so then it can improve the condition of the grower. I am sharing the what are the major issue in the poly house and net house cultivation. So these are major problem grower is facing and wilt is one of the major issue because grower grow the same crop in land. And not going for rotation because they didn't know the crop because capsicum is capsicum and cucumber is cucumber he's taking. So grow has to follow certain crop rotation and he go for trichoderma the treatment so that he can save the crop. I also mentioned nematode is one of the issue in case of because grower not going for crop rotation, so it is a big problem. So he should go for crop rotation. And maybe certain chemicals also available like a value prime from Bayer is also controlling this nematode. So, but better he go for crop rotation and he go for this green manuring and so that will save the crop. He has to go for solarization also. So solarization also very important. Normally grower is not going because he want to earn more money and that's the reason actually if he not go for solarization. So all these wild tomatoes, inoculum maintained in the soil and when you grow the crop it affect the crop and finally lose the yield. Portability is another concern, so but it can be maintained easily with the certain fungicide in the market, so grower to take in care. Thrips and mites are the big issue in case of poly house and net house. So the issue is actually he not properly managed maintain the poly or net house, so there is a holes entry point in the entry gate and he not proper repairing the in case of there is hole in poly on net house. So if you maintain properly then this problem will not happen like this way. This is the actual field and there is no growth and so there are certain chemical is available so he can follow these chemical to control this disease, but it's mainly how you can he can maintain his poly of net house very properly. Nutrition is very important aspect because when you compare with the open field, in capsicum you are getting 20-25 ton per acre. When you go for poly house, so it is he achieves the 40-50 up to 60 MT achieving the yield. So it is not used follow the same nutrient solution. So it should be maintained as per the soil condition, local condition, and what is your yield targets. Sanitation is very important. I just highlight here when I visit many poly house net house. So I just they are not properly managed. Their poly house net house weeds are there, and they no proper pruning. And I just show in next slide what the key problem we are facing in net house poly house. So there is need to increase the operational efficiency in PGH. So there should be double door entry in protected greenhouse as required to control pests. So normally what happens, it is normally one door and two doors are not properly installed. So what happens, this all this might issue there. So door should be closed properly. When you enter in, there should be two gate system. And when you enter in one gate, immediately close the gate. When then enter the cross the next gate, to immediately close the gate. So what happened when we discuss with Grover this thing, he says, Saab, labor sunta nahi hai, manta nahi hai. So we have given the training, but labor is not listening. So what is happening? I show in the last slide, actually, the thrips mites issue is happening due to these issues. Immediate repair is very important in case of PGS. What happened, there is a hole, so something wear and tear is there. So immediately prepare the poly or net house. Otherwise, your insect will enter. And there is a very congenial environment in the poly or net house. So otherwise, you have to, it is very difficult to control the thrips and mites. It is another way how to control these thrips, mites, and white fly. Use sticky trap for blue and yellow color. So when you use this, so professionally cut down, and you can get good yield in this poly or net house. Go for mulching. So maybe control all the weeds, but it not just use mulching and you can control the weeds. Weed also grow inside of the this net house on poly house also. So maybe remove all these weeds, properly weed out. And because it harbor the pest, so properly weed out these weed, then you can have very good control of pest in poly house, net house. So this is mitigation plan. So what we discussed, there are challenges. Now we discuss on the mitigation plan. So cost effective design of greenhouse. So there should be need of economic design. So normally this poly or net house system depend on this government subsidy. So if economic design level, then they can go for this poly house or net house structure. What I mentioned this earlier, this temporary structure of net house, grower is installed with own money. There is no subsidy in that case, and cost is around 2 to 3 lakh per acre. So we need more poly house and net house structure with the economic pricing, so that grower can use this. Second thing is very important is standard package and practices, because our soil is different, climate is different, and grower target is very different. So maybe there should be standard package and practices, and grower can follow those practices so he can improve the yield. Disease and pest management is very important, because greenhouse follow provide fabric condition for grazing of these pests, follow crop rotation to manage nematodes, and effective and eco-friendly measures needed to like IPM type of control is implemented in managing pests and diseases in protected structures. They need to develop suitable varieties for Indian condition. So maybe some companies are working on this part. And maybe we can see in India, currently most of the hybrids came from other countries. So these areas need more focus. And lastly, right price of produce. You need more attention. If grower has good money, then he can pay money for seeds, pesticide, and his poly house, net house repair. Normally he has no money because he's getting very less price of his produce. So this is the area need attention. So thanks to government initiative, because they are providing a subsidy to all these structure. So state government, center government are providing subsidy, and it is for, they are providing even for seeds, drip and mulching, and they're providing from 50 to 90% subsidy. I was showing this example, actually, I like this because Japanese are very innovative, and what happens, self-reliant by growing vegetable and grain in office. But India, we cannot think about this concept. So there is a building, Parson Urban Farm, is a 9-story office building in Tokyo. And they have around 20,000 square meter area. So of this 20,000 square meter area, so 4,000 square meter area they allotted to grow vegetables. So you can see here how they grow vegetable in the office. And it is rice and it's vegetable they grow. And you see the building is full of this vegetables. So it is very innovative idea. And we also use this. We can use this at our home level. So we grow vegetable. So what happened with this technique? They're getting the fresh and like insect-free vegetables for their canteens. The potato crop is also a new platform for new innovative techniques, because normally you can control the climatic condition like in other countries, but in India you cannot control because these are naturally ventilated polyhouse. But some instruments are available in the like Way Beyond company in the Europe and GrowFit from Israel. This instrument is very good, and they give you about the temperature, CO2, radiation, and this soil moisture also they are providing. And what happened, you can have access on the app, so you can see what is the climate condition. You can link with all these data through disease and insect pressure, and based on your history you can go for following the control measures, and also give some idea of the yield also. So these are the very good technique, not in India, but in future we can see this technology in India. This is a future farming. Normally we are facing labor issue, but in future we can see this type of robotics in harvesting. So they can harvest tomatoes and capsicum. So you can give programming, and they can on that same time go and harvest the crops. So this is very good technology. So currently these technology are not as efficient as human harvest the fruit, but now in future maybe we can see more improvement in these technologies. So you can see this is the outcome in potato cultivation in vegetables. So grower getting high yield, rather he's getting high ROI. So you see in all these this poly house and rectangular structure, yield is quite high compared to open field. So this area, when grower is using this, that's the reason grower is focusing on, grower go for this poly house net house structure, they can increase the yield. So this is one another area, this vegetable exotic crop export. Currently, you see the India, we have only 1% export share in the global level. So you see the our condition, we have very good labor, very good soil, and people are very trained. So we have more scope, we can increase our this share from 1% to the 5% or 10% in future. In potato cultivation, you can get healthy produce with good taste and high nutritional value and safety, because normally crop grow in nature condition if grower properly maintain his poly house net house. So and it give additional value to the grower also. Many times he's getting additional value in the market also. This is smart agriculture, very sustainable, because normally it supply full year vegetables to the end customer. So it is very good technique, and grower had to use this technology. One of the good thing with this technology, normally we see in the rural area there is a problem of employment. So normally we are talking about the only labor. So now with this technology, so when you move in rural areas, you find consultant, you find technical labor, you can technology hungry, and they need more knowledge, they need more training to understand this technology. So it really generate good revenue and good employment in rural areas. And also we are supporting to provide training also to all these people also, they can support the growers. So one of the important thing in case of reverse brain drain, normally when you see the problem in rural areas, people move from village to cities, but there is a reverse brain drain. So now people moving from city to the farm. So there is a huge investment in this potato cultivation. You can see good cultivation investment in Hyderabad and Bangalore. So like tangle form is one of the example, and itinerary form in Bangalore. So there are many examples. People are investing a lot of money, and it creates some interest among the rural youth to go in this, follow this technology. And I think it is a good awareness and good outcome of this technology. I am sharing some this example for actually how these are outcome of a study in Haryana, and this paper was published. They compare this open field with the protected cultivation. So, and it is a, they use capsicum hybrid. So normally I just give the outcome also, high ROI. Normally in case of peaches, they got 1,84,000 rupees, and versus 60,000 rupees in open field. So it's 2 times more than what you got from the open field. Water saving 41%, weed control and long earning period, and crop safe from rainstorm, and consistent earning actually, because duration is long, so you get the more yield compared to the open field. So this technology is very good. You can get more yield compared to the open field. And this another example for cucumber cultivation in Haryana. So they also conducted some experiment to know what is the ROI. So ROI is quite high. It is 1,44,000 in 1 acre, and compared to 47,000 in open field. So it is 2 times more than the return you get in open field. So there is a water saving and weed control here. And it is same long earning periods and safe from rain, storm, and good earning for long period. So you see, this technology is very good. There are multiple time return than conventional method of growing the crop. It is a grower wise, just to take some input from growers. So like this is a grower, Bansilal Patidar from Ratlam. So he planted cucumber and poly house and earned around 6.5 lakh for 1 acre from 2 seasons. And it is Raghunath Patil from Sangli. He say, I like to grow capsicum in poly house as it give me high return than open field cultivation. I return my bank loan also. So this good sign when grower is using this technology, their income will increase and they make their life happy. So now I take you what Syngenta role in this protected cultivation. So Syngenta is a very strong in protected crops. They are world leader, and they focus more on high value added disease tolerant hybrid, and they are leader in capsicum, and have a strong portfolio in tomato and cucumber. And Syngenta is working both on AGH and PGH hybrids. So we have the 6 hybrid currently in the market. So these are very different hybrids, and you can see Serene, Bokane, Gasella, Lumos, Camos, and Kyoto. So all hybrids are very different requirement as per grower. The Serene is very good for this, have very good heat, this cold tolerance. Bokane has very good heat tolerance, and it has bottom humidity tolerance also. And Lumos is a very good shiny fruit. And Kamosh is very good hybrid. It is yellow, and it has a powdery mildew and nematode tolerance. Kyoto is another hybrid. It has very good powdery mildew and nematode tolerance. So normally Kyoto, it is a normally what happens in this hybrid, we see from hot to cold or cold to hot. Ink of Selene, it is very good for hot to cold, and Bokane is good for cold to hot condition actually. Same Kamosh is very good for this. Hot to cold, and Kyoto is good for cold to hot condition. So normally we see our season, like go for planting in June, July, it is like hot condition. When you go December, it is a cold condition. When you go in May, June, it is a hot condition. So we have very specific hybrid as per requirement for the growers. So we have 3 hybrids in cucumbers, like Kafka, Brua and Bitney. So Brua is basically for summer season, and Kafka and Bitney for this post rainy season and winter. So Kafka have a very good downy mildew tolerance, and Bitney also same very good downy mildew tolerance. So all 3 hybrids are multi-distillate. So we have one hybrid Roman for growers, and it is grown in the polyhouse condition. So normally it give a very good yield, around 7 to 8 kg per plant, and it has round shape, and weight is around 90 to 100 gram. So normally you go for proper pruning and staking of these hybrids, it gives very good yield. This is one of the good achievement of Syngenta. It is young tomato. It is not in India, but in other country, Europe. It got the Fruit Logistica Innovation Award in 2020. So you see here, the size is 30 to 40 gram, and it is purple shape, and rich in high level anthocyanin, vitamin and minerals, and unique combination of amino acids and volatile compound. So it is very rich tomato hybrid. And the reason is actually why I show here, because if such hybrid in the market, really grower get more money and better price compared to normal hybrid, so increase the income of the growers. So these are two value added products, so Carotena and Valentina. So Carotena is yellow and Valentina is purple color. So Carotena is rich in vitamin A and Valentina is rich in anthocyanins, good for health. Because I mentioned we are innovative products, it is good for health, so we can improve our health also. So these are two products. These are not for polyhouse, normally grow in open field, but due to health benefits I am showing here. So finally, increasing awareness for healthy food is very important, because we need healthy fruits which are less pesticide. So there is an increasing awareness among customer for how to get the healthy food. Some use natural, some use organic. So Protect Solution is one way to get the healthy foods. So these are some health benefits from Protect Solution. So minimize use of pesticides. Normally when you use polyhouse and net house, so there is a protection for, so insect net is used. So insect cannot enter in the net house and poly house. So you get so what happen, end customer get healthy vegetable with low MRL. So and you can get the year round vegetables from this poly house net house. So it is one of the major benefits. You can minimize the use of pesticide, so you are getting a healthy and quality produce. So produce is very healthy and is good for family and children, because everybody care about this family. So it is one way that you can provide a good and healthy vegetable. So these are rich in vitamin C, iron, magnesium and phosphorus, because they are grow like a nature condition, so they maintain this nutrition level. And last one, reduce risk to farm labor actually, because what happen, because it not we cannot, there is no need of spraying pesticide in the polyhouse net house we go. But normally when there is limited spray, so what happens, so labor is less exposed to this pesticide, and he can maintain his good health, and so we can production. So it's good for the labor also. So this is my last slide. It is very sustainable and safe and high quality production. So safety is the first priority, and you can get quality produce. And continuity is very important, because what I mentioned, the healthy fruits or healthy vegetables you get through this technology around the year. And although the percentage of proportion of this net house condition and poly condition, I say it is less than 5% if you see the overall area we have, but in the future it will grow, and people are see the benefits of this technology, and we feel area will increase, and people get more healthy vegetable fruits for their shelf. Yeah. So let's enjoy healthy food, and because it is very important, we can maintain our immunity level by eating this healthy food. So thank you very much. Yeah.
thank you, Dr. Navneesh, for giving the elaborate picture of protected cultivation, starting from its history. to the utility, to the common public. I will come little later. Now I request Dr. Rajan to kindly give some remarks on his presentation briefly.
And we compliment Dr. Navneet Singh for his excellent talk on the protected cultivation that is very well connected with the health, and he has very explained all the opportunities which we have and challenges. This is an interesting story, starting from the hobby to the present status, the need of the hour, and his experience particularly in this area has very well, I should say, explained that why the population pressure is now forcing us to go for such type of options. And several advantages are there. Those are obvious: off-season production, then adverse climate we can handle very well, water saving is there, high quality produce is there, then barren land can be utilized for the production, cultivation, multiple crops can be grown. So many advantages have been given, examples have been given by him. And different the components of different types of a greenhouse, and he has explained very well, and how the different components mainly related with the soil, soilless culture, hydroponics, aeroponics have been explained. The innovations in the greenhouse technology, those are the it has to be considered with the growth of this industry, and very well explained, and uses in different areas where we can utilize it. Also beautifully given the economy structures, the temporary net house, how people are using it, and how economics is involved, the per square meter production cost, as well as what may be the option for the resource poor, enthusiastic progressive farmer. Then another example of the costliest one, retractable roof system, where although yield is high, but the cost is also high. Then future of the poly house or greenhouse, that also combines with the vertical farming. Then harvesting of the rainwater particularly, and several examples have been given in different industries are using these structures for their commercial production. The nursery industry is the one of the example. The breeding programs are based on that. Seed production is coming up on that, and he has also given the constraints related with the greenhouse technology, how the high cost is important, but it how it can be beneficial, and it is it can be converted for the how it is useful for and satisfying the needs for the Indian condition, the low cost structures, the cost of production, then the major constraints also he beautifully explained, like wilt, nematode, powdery mildew thrips, nutrient deficiencies, and sanitation. These are some of the major points, but some more important things also he has indicated, as how the solutions can be given to the problems, and why the carelessness of the labor is sometimes we have to pay for that, and mitigation plan, how it can be very well taken. The innovation technology, innovation in techniques, for the this automation that is coming up, robotics also some beautiful example has been given, and the application of the smart horticulture can be possible in this protected cultivation structures only. Mostly we can go for that, and also he has given the beautifully what is the contribution of Syngenta for this protected cultivation. Definitely their contribution as not only as per his description, the varieties, but other areas also. The Yum tomato, a novel hybrid, and many other hybrids he has given, the details of those are well known to us now. And I should say this is in totality A to Z of with explained with his long experience, what are the research needs, innovations, innovatives. Particularly, he has given one example of Japan. We all are thankful to him for this beautiful example and big examples, and he is sharing of sharing experience with us. And this is one of the area which is very much required for the sustainable and safe production of the healthy horticulture produce. Thank you very much.
Dr. Rajan, you. Your institute is also doing R&D on protected cultivation.
Yes, sir.
If you wish, you can add your some important one or two points from your institute, if you feel like.
Sir, we are combining protected cultivation with now newer methods, like we have come up with different models of hydroponics and aeroponics. But limitation is that we have to go for the Indianized models where hydroponics and this aeroponics, etc. are there, because the cost of cooling and the limitation, limited number of crops, and particularly the extreme summer season, that is a limitation in the our conditions. That's why we are trying to economize it or make a package of practice with the low cost structures, machines, and also we are making some innovations in that, how a person can utilize this technology, this technique, for particularly for northern India and North Indian conditions where the extreme climate is we are facing.
Good, very good. Dr. Kalia, would you like to add some?
Okay, sir. Thank you. I think we have had a very nice talk, and very nicely Dr. Rajan has moderated it, touching each and every point Dr. Navneesh has mentioned. Being a futuristic technology, and viewers must have been benefited, as time and again Dr. Navneesh mentioned that it's awareness which will bring fruits tomorrow. So from that point of view, it was a very nice talk we have had. But looking for nutrition and health especially, although generally we know that vegetables and fruits are naturally nutritional rich. But today's demand is that in the market, when we have to put up our produce, the vital nutritional profiling should have been labeled. So that, because the educated community always look what nutrients, especially variety which has been put up in the market, it contains compared to others. And also when we are comparing the protection, protected cultivation with the open cultivation, we are showing the benefit that we have, we know that they are there already. But then what are the nutrient differences when we grow the crop inside and bring out to the market, and the open market, open field crop grown, what are the nutritional differences that we need to know in the future so as to make it more attractive to the literate consumers that we are having, and they are looking forward for the crops which are coming out from the protected cultivation point of view. And also from giving the marketing profit also, from that point of view, these, although from production point of view, Dr. Lewis has highlighted that product is quite high, and we are aware that is there, which is giving benefit to the growers. The sporadic growers who are growing presently, they are getting benefit of it. But as the farming increases, and there is a more production comes out, the profit margin will reduce. The price in the market will go down, and the cost of cultivation from protected cultivation is very high. So how it will be, I think from a nutritional point of view, and much more health benefits, they need to be highlighted from the consumer's point of view, so that there is further awareness amongst the consumers. And especially from the, as we in IERI started, that was the first demonstration, of course, in India, from protected cultivation point of view with Indo-Israel program. And we initiated some program in the later years to develop Indianized varieties, because where to the imported seed is very costly for the small and marginal farmers. It's beyond their reach to buy those seeds. So if we can develop indigenous varieties, it would be beneficial for small farmers, especially who would be looking forward for these crops. They have small land. So especially some varieties in cucumber from IRI has come, from Pantnagar has come, which are picked up by some farmers who are growing, getting benefited from it, which are low cost and the small farmers, and also in cherry tomato, a lot of varieties from different institutes has come out, and but cherry crop itself is not in much demand. It's a sporadic, very less need. But tomorrow it may be much more. From that point of view, it's better that we have varieties in hand and then popularize the technology and benefits of it. And then overall, the technology is so good to harness, to get the new graduates coming looking for job here and there, they can concentrate upon with this white collar job for them. So the attraction of the graduates or postgraduate students to start their venture under Skill India program, they will be getting much more benefited, as government is also promoting such programs where from the larger community will be benefited, and nutritional crops will be more available at nominal rates to the growers. So with that, I think we have a very good talk, and and it's good that the private sector is investing on it and started investing. Earlier, we haven't seen much private sector is working on this aspect. So Syngenta is doing good job that they are popularizing this program and bringing new varieties, telling which are the varieties performing well. But the nutrition profiling, if also it's done, that will add to it, add to the cap of Dr. Navneesh. So with that, I thank the speaker very much for a nice talk. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Collier. I think if some questions are there, they can be displayed. Questions, if any. How long protected cultivation will need subsidy to keep itself going? A question from Dr. Harihar Ram, a well-known vegetable scientist of the country. Navneesh ji, would you like to?
So actually, yeah, I will really answer, because you see the current scenario, this technology, because the cost is very high. In case of polio, say 30-35 rupees per acre, and net house, it is 15 to 20 lakh rupees per acre. For grower, it is very high cost. Normally, you see the life cycle also in case of net house, it cycle is 5 to 8 years, and poly house, it is 10 to 15 year maximum. So you see the depletion, all these things. So cost is to why it is surviving only due to this government subsidy. And what I mentioned, one example, there is a customized temporary net house texture, quite popular in Maharashtra and Karnataka. So maybe those who are not depend on this subsidy. So maybe we should have some customized, Indianized technology, then grower will spend this money. And I really simply say, even in case of this subsidized poly or net house, grower had limited taking care, because he has thought it is government money in 1 year. But normally the net house, we observe the grower has own money, he is taking more care. So I agree with you. Because government needs subsidy, it is going on. But I think the current stage, I feel it will be going on.
मैं आपको रोक रहा हूँ नवनीत जी. मेरे विचार से जो मेरी समझ में आया है वो ये है, डॉक्टर हरिहर राम का क्वेश्चन कि आपकी प्रोटेक्टेड कल्टीवेशन अपने पैरों पर कब खड़ी होगी.
डॉक्टर साहब, ये लग जाएंगे टाइम, 5-10 साल लग जाएंगे इसमें करीब.
Next question. Metro pillars in Delhi at many places have been covered with the vertical garden for beautification purposes. It appears to be cost intensive practice. What is your opinion on such type of horticulture? Would you like to answer it, or should I react to it?
Yeah, Doctor, you are expert, you can give.
No, I'm not expert. Anyway, Ravindra Raina ji, this is desirable. Why it is desirable, what purpose it is serving, we are aiming at improving the environment or metros, and improvement of the environment is one of the objectives of our horticulture where we are taking up extensively these vertical gardens. Vertical gardens, mostly the metro pillars and others, and even big government houses, restaurant, hotels, and others, as well as airports. These vertical gardens are coming up. They may not be profitable or can't be profitable, but their value, I think we can't evaluate in terms of money, as they contributing towards the improvement of environment. But this vertical gardening technology itself requires lot of improvement. What it is in the present condition is not that very effective. Next question, please.
These are the only questions.
Okay, thank you. So with these words, I think I must thank the speaker, the co-organizers. They have nicely commented upon and given lot many new suggestions. We had this evening very sober talk, very sober one, but it is full of information. It's full of information on that protected cultivation and this climate change will enforce protected cultivation. Subsidy or no subsidy, protected cultivation is going to prevail upon, and it is coming up. The answer to that coming up is that, you know, the riverbed cultivation is a protected cultivation since AGDD is coming up. And now there is a lot of improvement in that, and we are using the no tunnels for raising the early crops of cucurbits and others throughout the country. If you visit in the month of January, February, March, you will see the fields covered with the low tunnel. That is a protected cultivation. And in some people do use mulching, plastic mulch. Plastic mulch, as Dr. Navneet also told, it not only gives you the early yield, but it saves on water and on weedicide. There is no need of weeding there because weeds do not come up. So mulching and this low tunnel technology are coming up, followed by what he emphasized, the net houses. Net houses cost is not unaffordable by the farmers. The farmers can easily afford the, is a mere machardani sort of a thing for the crop. As we use the machardani in our houses, you can use the machardani or the net house in your field to that extent. So not very expensive, and these net houses are becoming very popular, not only in Punjab, but in Karnataka. I have seen in place of naturally ventilated poly house, you see more of a net house or insect proof net houses. They are there. But what is required particularly from the farms like Syngenta and others, and as well as the government agencies, the agriculture universities, the horticulture institutes, large number in our country, they should come up with suitable varieties and hybrids for these protected cultivation. That is what lacking. If that much is done, we can make a lot of improvement in that. And where the subsidy factor is there, subsidy, wherever it is properly utilized, is paying the dividend. It's not that it's not. It is paying the dividend. People have established the nursery supply. They are supplying the nursery of seedlings. I think the era of getting the vegetable seed is gradually diminishing. People are getting the seedling, they prefer the seedling, and it's better to have the seedlings, as he also emphasized. And not only seedling, the grafted seedlings. Grafted seedling will take care of this, your nematode and whatever other problems he has pointed out, some of the things are taken off. So grafted seedlings, they are to be done under protected conditions nicely, or they will be healthy under the protected cultivation. The so-called the advanced high-tech horticulture or smart horticulture has to take the help of the protected cultivation only where this your vertical farming, I tell you, the vertical farming is going to be the future, I don't know agriculture, but the future horticulture, particularly the vegetables and medicinal plants and flowers, they are going to be there. And kindly don't be afraid and don't think otherwise. The vertical farming, hydroponic, aeroponics, these things you can do outdoor also. And we are laying emphasis on that. Outdoor also it is possible, only thing that we have to take the seasonal crop, not that any crop any time or around the year you can have the same type of crops. So there also it is important. And the another important point which he has emphasized is the use of wasteland. Where the agriculture can't be done, use these technologies under protected structures, you can make use of that. Land is sinking, major problem, but you have got huge wasteland that is there. So what I seeing in nutshell, the protected cultivation will improve upon provided we pay due attention at appropriate level. What I mean over here by saying that, see, if I put the protected structure, some naturally ventilated poly house or some other poly house, if some problem is there, I keep looking for who will repair, who will do the needful here and there, and from where I will get the input, etc. It becomes a big problem. So if we think of the cluster approach to the protected cultivation, we should develop the clusters of protected cultivation where you can have the input supply or the services supply there only. That will be, I think, the practical answer to that. If we are doing it sporadically, it will be difficult. You won't get the services. But it has to be taken up at the appropriate level, at the policy level, or whatever the departments who are responsible for that, they have to give due emphasis to that. Including the National Horticulture Board, they can evaluate their subsidy regime and answer the questions like that of Dr. Hariyar Ram, how long it will continue. So with these words, I thank profusely to the speaker, Dr. Navneet Singh. Sir, you have really worked hard, put up a good show. We are happy, and I am thankful to my colleagues, Dr. Pritam Kalia and Dr. Rajan, who are supporting nicely, supplementing the talks of the speakers. And I'm sure the viewers are benefited with our arrangement of things, something I say, and we give the floor to the speaker, and then Dr. Kalia and Dr. Rajan takes care of that. My friend Dr. D.P. Singh says something, should I read it? Thanks for the replies made by Dr. Shailendra, Dr. Kalia, and finally by Dr. Brahm Singh. Congratulations to the speaker for a nice talk. Really, I feel obliged. My all colleagues are attending the program, the webinars. So I'm really thankful to them. I don't know how to pay back that. I think I should put up a still better show. And think of some novelties so that they remain intact, they should not run away. I want them and get constant encouragement by their presence, Dr. K.V. Peter, Dr. D.P. Singh, and then some Yogesh Ji were there, and some boss of, I think, Navneet was also there, Dr. Tikku was there, and many more. Sorry, I'm not naming all, but number of them are there that gives an encouragement at least to me and my colleagues. We assure that we will try to improve upon, as the protected cultivation and other things we are trying to improve upon, we will try to improve upon our presentation or webinar also. So friends, with this, I thank one and all again profusely. Very good evening, I think we had with a lot of information. And we meet next Tuesday. Next Tuesday, whether somebody can project the next Tuesday topic if it is ready. Next Tuesday topic, Dr. Tikku will be the speaker. I don't know whether. Good. It is there. You can see the next talk is consumer-oriented breeding of solanaceous fruit vegetable. ये बड़े टेक्निकल बंदे हैं, बड़ी अच्छी अच्छी टर्म्स लाते हैं. साफ सोलेनेशियस फ्रूट वेजिटेबल्स आर टोमेटो, कैप्सिकम, ब्रिंजल, उस कैप्सिकम में चिली भी आ जाता है और शिमली मिर्च भी आ जाता है. तो उन तीनों फसलों के बारे में हम सुनेंगे, कैसे इम्प्रूवमेंट उसमें लाया जाता है, उसमें खास करके क्वालिटी पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से हेल्थ एंड हैप्पीनेस. एंड ए वेरी एक्सपीरियंस स्पीकर has agreed to deliver a talk, Dr. Surendra Kumar Tikku ji, who is co-founder and director, research and development at Terra Seed Science Private Limited, Pune. So with these words, I say bye-bye to all. We will meet again same time on Tuesday. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Good night.
Good night.
Good night.